I think everyone is interested in how feelings evolve and how they're created, what goes on in the brain and in the body to actually make emotions happen. You know, how do all these feelings that actors have to display on stage, how do they happen night after night after night?
A person can be watching something and the same part of their brain will light up as what the person who's portraying somebody is either doing or saying.
That's part of the magic of theater, mm-hmm. that we actually go through these things on stage so that the audience will feel what the character went through, mm-hmm. either something really fun or something really tragic without having to actually go through it themselves.
As one of our outings, I think it'd be really interesting to show a student really what an MRI machine, you know, looks like and what it will show.
Some people look at what the actor does and they think it's some kind of mystical thing, that there are some people who are just kind of born with this thing, and that the reality is it's a craft. And through repetition, you can learn crafts that you sit back and think, oh, well, I don't have talent.
I would like the students to gain some appreciation, not only of the gelatinous mass, but also the fact that there's a lot of organization in there, and that's where their personality is. They are who they are today, but tomorrow that brain is plastic and they could be changing it. Do I make myself clear?
You make yourself very clear, Dan. And I'm excited about learning about all those things.
You're going to take my class too?
I am. I'm going to sit in on your class.
Okay.